You might want to cover your eyes for this one, Billy, because what you're about to see is not for the faint-hearted. Hello once again, YouTube, and welcome back to The Domain, Community Spotlight, Episode 6. We're getting quite old now, friends. We are here once again to celebrate all the very best of the Mega Constructs community, and it has been over a month since we did the last one. It has been a very, very, very crazy month. And it's also kind of crazy that we're following this straight after our diorama competition on Discord. We just finally that competition. There were over 280 entries for our versus diorama. I would highly recommend you going and checking that out. But this is our community spotlight, and this is focused around our Facebook group, the Mega Constructs Domain. If you've not joined yet, it is the center stage for all collecting in the galaxy. I'm very proud of it, and our community and our admin team are just doing a really great job out there. So every month we have a theme. We collate together all of the best posts around that theme from the month. Last month it was best custom figures, and this month it's best pop and swaps, which I was very excited about this one particularly. Not because I was gonna see maybe much talent, just I was gonna see some weird stuff. I wanna see a mix between really cool pop and swaps and also nightmarish ones. And I can guarantee about 80 to 95% of them were nightmare fuel. So we're gonna go through my top 25 today. And for the uninitiated, this is how pop and swaps work. You take two characters and you make basically nightmare fuel. This is what you made. It's not for this world. It's not as mega intended, but you know what? If you're gonna make a construction product, people are gonna start abusing it. So I give you for the first time, Grunt Didact. This is I'm a talented man. All right, so that's how pop and swaps work. This might become a new sticker on the Discord. This is quite wonderful. We've got 25 pop and swaps. Let's start going down the list, friends. Number one is from Aiden Char. A lot of these names make it into every spotlight, but I made sure to include some new faces as well. So Aiden Char did a very simple one. He got the new, is it Sam Fisher? Sam Fisher? Sam Fisher? Is it Sam Fisher? Is his name Sam Fisher? Sam Fisher? Sam Fisher? It's Sam Fisher. He got the new Sam Fisher Mega Constructs Heroes figure. He popped and swapped it with some ODSTs and some Spartans, and the result is extraordinary. I love Covert Ops figures, so I wanted to start with this one. But you know, the seriousness wasn't gonna last for even a couple of seconds. We're on to Joan Manuel, and they made this elite drone thing. I don't even know. That's a really weird one. And then Harrison Kalinowski made what even is that? A Spartan's body with an elite's head, flood arms, and jackal legs. Jackal legs. No, that has never been done before. That is a world first. Luke LaPierre had a really nice, very simple pop and swap of a recon helmet with an ODST body. And then Dane Coates had a nice pop and swap as well. Sort of that blue and yellow is going off that whole security theme that we've had in a lot of sets, especially the exosuit. So I really respect this one. Nathaniel Klink. He took the AC Pelican Brohammer and then swapped it onto some basic Marines to kind of make them like translucent Power Rangers. I don't know exactly what they're meant to be, but they're so cool. I literally forget the ones that I've saved, and then I flip to the next one and I'm like as mortified as I was to begin with. This is from Isaac Newhurst. He put Guilty Spark's head on a hunter's body, which honestly, it kind of works quite well. It's definitely going on the thumbnail for sure. And I would like the chat to sort of start naming some of these. That would be great. You know, he's come back in the books as some kind of Promethean soldier. I'd expect him to come back like a war machine like that. That is horrendous. James Schneider, they're all so ridiculous. He got the Master Chief helmet that comes with the new Last Man Standing set, and he popped it on a body. I wonder how easy that is to do. That's it. That's what he did. Jose Mercado. Now, I've seen this one for a while. This was one of the trending pictures on our group a while back. What even is this? Is that like a cabal leader with a brute's head, a hunter's arm? This one is really impressive, really impressive. Some of them are serious, not many, but the serious ones stand out. They're really cool. FNY Motion, go sub to him on YouTube. Really cool guy. This is not as cool as him. This is not very cool at all. This is like a hunchback Marine inside a grunt. A marine, well, a grunt's inside a marine, I think. I don't know which way around. Dalton Murray. Jackal got swole. Jeremiah's sick of us making fun of him on the Discord, so he's armed up. He's ready to take the fight to our Discord. Godspeed, Discord admins. He's coming. And then we've got Hong Kong Large Map by Peggy Lees. Why is that? No, it literally says number 11. I don't know. It's your map and it says number 11.
That's just my...
I know, that's just...
It just saved onto your computer.
And it might have just sorted as the number 11 for the spotlight. All right, well, go check out Peggy McDoodles on Instagram. I don't know how this picture got in there, but go check out her work. She's done some Halo maps. Really cool. Anyway, the next on the list is from Connor Doran. And again, is that a brute bodyguard's body? And then a grunt's legs and head. It's great. I'm going to do a live stream very soon of just... pop and swapping. 100 days later, they have still not figured out I am Billy the Grunt. Austin Hoyd. Now, he put a flood on top of a marine and created this extendable arm. Definitely terrifying. I don't want to see that in Halo Infinite. Not at all. And then Mary Ellen's son actually did a really good job. A tactical marine with loads of different leg straps, a nice sort of neckerchief, and then a bulldog shotgun as well. Very good work. Always happy to see Patrick Horan back into the community. He did a very simple pop and swap recon. Awesome figure. And then George Andrad had a custom Veil. I like this one because Veil's quite a simplistic figure. She's not really got much armor. So I like that this is more fleshed out. And I love the idea that Veil would carry a sword with her. Maybe she's just gonna pull that out and start duking with some elites while she's training with them. Max Skarsgård had he's even put a caption on it. What is it? More brutes? Much worse. Craig Drone Grunt. Very, very weird. I am wondering if we're gonna have some new enemies in Infinite. Like, we have just been rocking Hunters, Elites, Grunts, and Brutes for forever. I don't want this to be in Halo Infinite, but maybe something else. Then William Stifter got the Master Chief's top torso on top of it. I think the Halo 3 Heroes Master Chief, or maybe the Halo 3 Warthog Run Master Chief. Love seeing William Stifter's work. I don't know about this one, but... he always does a good job. Ben Thompson did a similar thing. Again, it's equally nightmarish. I think this is just the bottom and the top of the same Master Chief. I'm not sure. Jimmy John holds the record for putting the most figures together. We've got a Promethean Watcher, Crawler, maybe a Spartan leg. And then he's took two of the Destiny torsos out and put one Jackal and one some Spartan. I don't even know. You decide. Connor Shaw is enacting Billy the Grunt's revenge. He's sick of Craig down treading him all the time, throwing him around like he's a walking grenade. He's taken the fight back to Craig. He's been beefing up on some whey protein shakes, and he's got a gravity hammer and a mangler. If he's not one of the hands of Atriox, 343, you need to make that happen. Emma Hogan, we always see her name around. Flood, pop and swap with a Marine, maybe a Spartan, with a nice assault rifle, looking great. Kieran Chin, a Marine's head with some grunt arms, a grunt's body on top of Elite's legs, then Elite's torso on top of some grunt. There's a lot of different things going on here. My brain's starting to hurt with all these weird pop and swap. There's only actually been about 3 or 4 serious ones. Silver Exia, they've got a Veil figure with Elite legs, which kind of makes sense, to be fair. Veil did train with the Elite, so it's not the weirdest one we've seen. I'll give it that. Not the weirdest one. And then Nutcracken Cult has an Elite's head, a knight, but then I'm confused because it's also got some weapons coming out of its middle. Maybe the arms, those like little spidery arms, are holding those weapons. You know, Promethean knights are the souls of humans, so maybe they can also be the souls of elites. Maybe this is an elite trapped in a knight. Who knows? We're gonna finish it off today with a serious one because genuinely I'm getting a headache from all these weird pop and swaps. We've got John Colin Waters. He's got a beefed out ODST. I love those sort of sleeveless ODSTs. It reminds me of the good old days of Red versus Blue. I'm happy we ended on that one, guys. I hope I didn't make you all a little too confused there. That was some weird, weird stuff. So that is the weird and wacky world of pop and swaps, everybody. I'm gonna add a slideshow to the end of this. There were just so many entries. I really wanted to talk about all of them. I guess you guys are probably wondering what the next theme is because this video is actually very late. So I wanted to do a very special competition and a very special community spotlight for the end of this month. Now, about a week ago, I premiered a very special video where I revealed full set images of the new Halo Infinite Blind Bag Series 3. And there was a very special character in that blind bag series, Victor the Grunt. And he's become quite a little meme, and it's got the attention of a lot of people, including Mega Constructs themselves. Victor the Grunt has the ability to become the new Craig the Brute, especially if he has a big part in the game. So I am offering up this Covenant customizer pack as a prize for the best meme created about Victor the Grunt. The Domain Community Spotlight Episode 7's theme will be Victor the Grunt, and it'll be premiering in only 2 weeks' time. If you can create the best meme focused around our boy Victor, you can go away with this Covenant Armory pack. To post your meme, head over to the Mega Constructs Domain Facebook group. That's the only place we'll be accepting the memes, and let the competition begin. And thanks so much for the ever-growing support on this community. There are so many exciting announcements coming soon, and you should definitely check out our live stream where we drew the winner for our Versus Diorama competition that gained like 283 entries. It was just so crazy. Stay awesome. Stay safe out there, and Billy the Grunt is signing off. Domain out. Also, hashtag Megamind Simon.